bring God's word. I want to share God's word. I want to share the word of Mungu. Kwa tika kaga, alafu tutaomba na ibada yetu itafika mwisho kwa leo. Namshukuru Mungu amekuwa mwema na amekuwa mwaminifu. Sisi tumemtumainia tu, tumeona kibali chake mwaka kufika hapa. Simwambie jirani yako na hiyo ni kiama. Hiyo ni muujiza yani. Hata wewe ya, yani actually you will be surprised. Hata wewe you are alive 2019 because you see there were many battles and struggles, but thank God I am. Uko sakasi, magonjwa, maradhi, matatizo, kukufungwa kwa kodi ya nyumba. You know what, you are not able to pay rent, but you are still there. By the way, you should thank God. Watu kwa kashushwa kazi kule unafanya, yani wakapunguzwa, na wakaenda nyumbani, na bado ukabaki. Sio ndio Mungu, anaitwa Mungu. Tumuishie mwaka huu wa open heaven. Na mwaka huu ni mwaka wa open heaven. Na tulianza hivyo katika mkesha wetu. That was the sermon that I had of open heaven. And I will continue sharing on open heaven. But I want first of all to say anything that is open, it has also the opposite, that thing which is closed. So what is open implies it to be closed, isn't it? So when we say the open heaven, we could say also a heaven can be closed. A heaven can be closed. 2 Chronicles 6:12. Solomon is dedicating the temple. Solomon is dedicating, and he talks about so many things. He talks about when the heavens are closed in verse number 26 of 2 Chronicles, and there is no rain in the land. He continued to talk about what would happen when the people pray. He says, when people pray facing this direction, open heavens, open the heavens, and the shower blessings of the Lord. So I think before we see what happens when the heavens are open, it's also good for us to know, to note that there are certain things that we may find ourselves because the heavens have been closed. And I pray that none of us will walk in a closed heaven this year, but that God will open the heavens for us, for the sake of you and for the sake of me, that there will be an open heaven for us. When the heaven is closed, your prayer line is full of failures. You pray, but it doesn't succeed. It's like you're knocking and the door is not opening. It's like the heaven is shut. It's like your prayers are bouncing back. So when your prayers are bouncing back, it simply means the heavens have been closed. You're walking under closed heaven. Under closed heaven. When you're walking under closed heaven, it's like there is silence. There is nothing is happening. It's like there are no movements. It is like God is silent. And we know for a long time the children of Israel suffered in Egypt. And they called upon God. But it appeared like God was silent until he says, I have heard the cry of my people. The heavens opened and God heard the cry of his people. So I pray that this year you're going to walk in a heaven that is open for you and that God will not be silent for you. That when you call, he will answer. When you call, he will hear you. He will communicate with you. Because when he is silent, things don't go very well. So we pray that in this year that God will not be silent concerning my issues, that I will hear him. Because when the heavens are closed for me, then I have nothing, and nowhere to run to. May the heavens be open for us so that we can have a place we can run to for our safety. When the heavens are closed, there will be some spiritual confusion. Actually, it is when the heaven is closed that people seek for help from here and there. Because it is, you're trying to get to God, but you cannot get there. You're trying to talk to him. There is some confusion down here. Everybody thinks they know it. When the heavens is closed, there will be spiritual barrenness. You barren, you're trying this in your spiritual endeavor, it's not working. There will be drought. You try this and you have hunger. You are thirsty. There is drought, your spiritual drought, if the heaven is closed. When the heaven is closed, there is some stagnation. You are not moving. It's like you're trying to move, you cannot go, because the heavens are closed. And I declare, in 2019, there will be no one of us that will be standing. We're going to move. I think you need to tell your neighbor, I'm moving. If you want to sit in my seat, I will allow you to. I'm moving. After fun, tell your neighbor, even that one in front, I will get there. I know some of you, when you ask to come to the front, you look at it. No, allow the momentum. I am moving. May the Lord move you to the next level. Blessed be the name of the Lord. There will be movement. There will be no barrenness. There will be no drought. When the heavens are closed, there is spiritual blindness. And I pray that none of us will be blind. We'll see well. Our inner eyes will be open. And we will see where the Lord wants us to take us. And we declare 2019, the devil will not rejoice over us. Because when the heavens is closed, the devil is like, he's so happy about us because we are not making any progress. When the heavens are closed, it's like you're in bondage. It's like you are in captivity. It's like you cannot move an inch. But when the heavens are open, tell your neighbor, when the heavens are open. When the heavens are open, man, I tell you, when the heavens are open, may God allow us to live in an open heaven. Because when the heavens are open, there are things that will happen in an open heaven that will trigger you and push you to the next level of your Christian walk with the Lord. Number one, Ezekiel, the book of Ezekiel, chapter 1 and verse 1. The Bible says, now it came to pass in the that year, the fourth month, in the fifth day of the month, as I was among the captives by the river of Sheba, that the heavens were opened, and I saw visions of God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If we look at that verse and break it a little, it will tell you certain things that are very critical to our walk, our Christian service. Among the Bible says, the 30th year. In other words, this man has been there for 30 years. It doesn't matter how long you've been there. Actually, he was there not only for 30 years. He was there 30 years, 4 months, and the fifth day. Yeah, he had counted everything. Yeah, he could not miss anything. Maybe he would have even saved the hours with the second and so on. But he was so eager because he had lived there for 30 years, for about 4 months and 5 days. Hallelujah. In other words, it does not matter where I am and for how long I've been there. It could be that year or 20 years. It could be 25. But I'm speaking even at your 30 years. May the Lord open the heaven for you so that he can usher you into what he has for you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I know you have been counting. Oh, I've been sick for 2 years. I've been sick for 3 years. I've been sick for 4 years. But I'm saying it doesn't matter. Keep on counting. But may the Lord, one of these days, cause your account to come to an end. Where you say on the 30th year, on the fourth day, on the fourth month, on the fifth day, I got my deliverance. May the Lord cause it to happen. I know you have talked about it. You have prayed about it. You have come to the pulpit here. People are praying for you. And you even get sometimes embarrassed to go into the same pastor to say the same thing. If I were you, I wouldn't. Because when that time comes, I will be the same pastor who say, after going for 20 times for prayer, finally the heavens were open. Because when the heavens are open, certain things are going to happen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Number two, I find in that scripture, is that Ezekiel will say, even though I was there for 30 years, and 4 months, and 5 days, I was a captive. And you know what? It doesn't matter what captivity you have been in. It will come a time that the Lord must break the captivity and set you free. Yani Mungu hakuna mtu ajui. Unajua saa hii unaweza ringa. Na unaweza vaa vizuri ni kuone kama wewe uko na kitu. Lakini Mungu anajua upungufu wako. He knows your weakness, he knows your challenge. And Ezekiel is saying, although I was a captive, he's not priding himself as a captive. He's only saying that God knew I was a captive, but the heavens were open. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And may God do likewise to us. It doesn't matter where we are, the captivity we are going through. May the time of a vision come. Maybe you have struggled as a singer. You have struggled as a businessman. You have struggled to get a visa to travel out. But I'm saying, like Ezekiel, naming the time, that finally I got it. Oh my goodness, you can see the glory of people that have tried something and finally they have got it. They come smiling all the way. And then this is the embarrassment that they have. You know, embarrassment in a kuwa hivi. Imagine that how could you listen to maswali? Because when the heavens are open, nobody should ask you a question. And I could listen to your name. Imagine, they only ask me, you want to go to America, for how long do you want to move? And I was carrying a file like this, like your deeds, long book, your guide, marriage certificate, and those. And they never asked, because the time they were asking you is because the door was closed. But when the door is open, when the heavens is open, as Ezekiel is saying, it does not matter. I could be a slave, I could be in captivity, but when the door is open, the vision is clear. May the Lord open the heavens for you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. It was on the 50th day of the month. And as I was among the captivity, the thing that I find here is that Ezekiel is saying, I was in captivity and doing what captives do. It does not matter what I do. Whether I'm a teacher, whether I'm a farmer, whether I'm a driver, whether I am a pastor, it doesn't matter what I'm doing. As long as I'm faithful in what I'm doing, God will meet me there. And the thing that is so clear, Ezekiel is saying, I was among, but there is a possibility that the others did not see the vision. But Ezekiel saw the vision. I pray that God is going to open our eyes so that we can see what God has for us in an open heaven. Because open heaven means the Lord. He says, by the river. Maybe they were making bricks. Maybe they were doing certain things there. And God opened and gave them a vision. I want to say two things or three things thereabout, and then I'll be done. When God wants to speak to us and reveal himself to us, I say it again, it doesn't matter where we find ourselves. He will do it. And my prayer is that you will receive divine revelation that will bring you out of whatever captivity and bondage you find yourself. Because some of the bondage is ourselves. It's we that put limitation. May God cause us to come out from limitation. Whether they are limitations that we have put upon ourselves. I will never forget this girl in this church. She was applying for a manager's position. And the people applying it had masters. She had none. She was the Form 4 who had done some course, a certificate course. And she came to church and we prayed with her. I asked her, sister, do you want a job? She said, I want a job, but there are this and this. I said, now, let me ask you again. Do you want the job or you want the bat? Because if you want the bat, you will get the bat. And the bat is those guys you are mentioning. Then she said, I want the job. Do you want the job? She said, I want the job. Bring the papers, we pray. We prayed a simple prayer. The prayer is, God, may the favor of the Lord go before this girl. May the people that interview her not look at her performance in high school, but look at her performance and her labor. We are done that, right? Alipoulizwa maswali, akapita. Alipokuja Wednesday by Gustavi, kwa kanisa kalikuwa pale kadogo. Amefurahi, ananiambia, imagine, hata mamasters wote niliwaweka chini. Si wewe uliwaweka chini. Mlango ukiwa umefunguliwa, acha malengo yako. When you open that door, it does not matter who is ahead of you. Haijalishi nani yako mbele yako, inaitwa favor. Mwambie jirani yako ni favor. Na hiyo favor si ndio mlango umefunguka? What else are we looking for? It is the heaven that is open, which is called favor. May the favor of the Lord locate you. May the favor of the Lord locate you. It doesn't matter where you are. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So what then happens when the heavens is open? The first thing that I want to say happens is in verse number 3, where Ezekiel says, the hand of the Lord was upon me. The word of the Lord came expressly unto Ezekiel the priest, the son of Booz, in the land of Chaldeans by the river Sheba. And the hand of the Lord was there upon him. In other words, mkono wa Bwana. Mwambie jirani yako mkono wa Bwana. Mkono wa Bwana ukiwa juu yako, wewe ni zaidi ya mshindi. Mkono wa Bwana ukiwa juu yako, hakuna kitu ambacho kinaweza kuwa kinyume cha mkono wa Bwana. Mkono wa Bwana ukiwa juu yako inamaanisha atakupigania vita vile vipi. Mkono wa Bwana ukiwa juu yako inamaanisha atakuinua kwa sababu yeye ana uwezo mkuu. Mkono wa Bwana, may the hand of the Lord be upon you. May the hand of the Lord be upon you in your business and your studies. May the hand of the Lord be upon you. Ezekiel saw a vision, and what he saw is the hand of the Lord upon him. In other words, alijiamini, ameona mkono wa Bwana, maisha yake ikawa tofauti. Hebu Bwana atupatie watu mwaka huu katika hili kanisa wakaamini kama mkono wa Bwana uko juu yangu, mimi nitaweza kuwa zaidi ya mshindi katika jina la Yesu. Ezekiel bado anasema nilikuwa mtumwa, lakini mkono wa Bwana uko juu. Inamaanisha hivi, tunaweza kuwa tunafanya kazi na wewe, lakini mkono wa Bwana uko juu. Amen. Inaweza kuwa mimi ni house girl, lakini mkono wa Bwana uko juu. Inaweza kuwa hata sijui secondary ambayo nitaenda. Nilifanya form 1, nilifanya standard 8, na secondary hata sijui, lakini mkono wa Bwana uko juu yangu. Yaani sisumbuki. Inaweza kuwa nilifanya form 4, na kweli kabisa sikufanya vizuri nilipofikiria, lakini mkono wa Bwana uko juu yangu. Because when the hand of the Lord is upon you, mkono wa Bwana ukiwa juu yako ni kibali. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The hand of the Lord was upon you. And I want you to go back a little bit and read a certain verses, maybe 1 to 10, about that passage. Let's read it together. Let's go back to verse number 1 up to 10, and then I'll summarize what I'm saying. Now it came to pass in the that year, blessed be the name of the Lord. We are talking about a guy who is in captivity. And in captivity, doing all what the captives are supposed to do and slaves, God starts to manifest himself to this man. This man in captivity, God speaks to him and starts showing him certain things that are very, very powerful. Imagine he is captive, and the Lord shows him a face of a man, the passion of a man. He shows him the hard working of an ox, the determination of an ox. He shows him the craftiness and the alertness of an eagle. And then he shows him the command of a lion. He is in slavery. Yani, yeye ni mtumwa, lakini Mungu anamuonyesha uso wa mtu, passion ya mtu. Inamuonyesha kwamba kuna nguvu kama ng'ombe, ox, anayenyuma. Kuna nguvu na hekima kama za mwewe. Ni mwewe hapana. Tai.
Alafu anasema kuna nguvu ambazo ni za simba. Na anamuonyesha mtu ambaye ni mtumwa. I'm saying this because there are some of us who have been intimidated by many things. But Ezekiel is not intimidated of his position and where he is because he sees a vision. And it is by seeing the vision that your life can be changed. It is by the revelation that God pours in your spirit that your life can change. First of all, to know, although you are a man, with the passion of a man, that God can give you the grace to be an ox to serve him, that God can give you the cleftness and the swiftness of an eagle, that God can give you the power and the muscle of a lion to be a king and to go and conquer. You're a slave, but God sees you as a conqueror. Look at your neighbor, tell the neighbor.
When I see you,
I see
a conqueror.
When
I see you,
I see
an eagle. When I see you,
I see
an ox. When I see you, I see a man.
Let's not believe ourselves when God sees the vision that God should bring to us in 2019 is the vision of conquerors.
Vizuri mwambie jirani yako conquerors. Fast ya kushinda. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to bring this to a close by sharing one more. One more. So there he is, Ezekiel, the son of Hus. The word of the Lord comes to him in that river, whatever he is doing, and the river is repeated even in verse 3 and verse 13 and so on and so forth. They keep on repeating it. But God shows him something else that I think is critical for us. Verse number 28. Verse number 28. As the appearance of the bowl that is in the cloud and the day of rain, so was the appearance of the brightness around about. This was the appearance of the likeness of the glory of the Lord. And when I saw it, I fell upon my face, and I heard the voice of one that spoke. Hallelujah. I heard the voice of one that spoke. Ezekiel is saying that I heard the voice. You see, Ezekiel is not just talking about things that are out there. Ezekiel is saying, I heard a voice. I saw the appearance, but I also heard a voice. When we see the glory of the Lord, how many people believe that when you see the glory of the Lord, your life changes? Your life actually changes. When you see the glory of the Lord, even your countenance changes. Sasa mtu kama ni roto, na anaruka-ruka, na wacha chakura, kwa kipika kwa hotelia, na hito anani okijani? Jogoshu. Nimeshinda, nimeshinda, na wacha chakura, kwa kipika kiunguwaru. So, continence inabalilika. Unaona mtu, nani kushinda, ameshinda, 50,000, or 1,000,000. When we see the Lord, our continence changes. Moses goes to the mountain, and he tells the Lord, I want to see your face. But the Lord tells him, no, if you see my face, you cannot leave. Anybody who sees my face dies. But you can see my glory. When Moses sees the glory of the Lord, the Bible records, even the glory of the Lord comes upon him. So when he goes down, the children of Israel don't want to look at him. They tell him, weka kiremba. Unika, your glory ni nyingi. And my prayer is that we will see the glory of the Lord so that our countenance will change. If a person sees the glory of God, the favor of the Lord, the provision of God, their life changes. And that is the prayer for 2019. Because it is an open heaven, my life will change. I'll see the glory of God. It will radiate upon me. And I'll hear the voice of the Lord. Because which report are you waiting for? Whose report are you waiting for? Unangoja report ya nani? Utaamini ya nani? Sauti ya Mungu. Ezekieli akasikia sauti ya Mungu na kaamaanisha, akajua pale kuna utofauti mkubwa. Ameona sauti ya Mungu. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Whoa. Hey, there are so many good things about this passage. Let's go back to verse number 26. And then I finish. This is the second time I finish. No, a good preacher finishes five times. So there are so many good things. Because when the heaven is open, There are things that happen. Verse number 26 says, and above the firmament that was over their head was the likeness of a throne, as the appearance of a sapphire stone. And upon the likeness of the throne was the likeness as the appearance of a man upon it. Oh, the vision that Ezekiel saw went beyond what he was seeing. It went beyond what he was seeing, and I pray that God can help you to see beyond what you see. Because what he saw on the throne, he saw someone appearing looking like a man. May we see on the throne, see Jesus the Redeemer. May we see Jesus the Healer. May we see Jesus the Provider. May we see God Elohim. May we see him, because in the vision, when we see him, our life will never be the same again. Even for Ezekiel, the life was not the same again. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Verse 24, and when they went, I heard the noise of their wings like the noise of great water, as the voice of the Almighty, the voice of speech, as the noise of the host. When they stood, they let down their wings. In other words, I'm saying, in this 2019, the year of the open door, may the angels of the Lord come and serve you. May the angels of the Lord come and serve you.
Amen.
I know some of you have been served by angels, but you give credit to the wrong people. Because angels look like you. Now look at your neighbor, tell them, you look like an angel. I know, I know. There is a guy who said we should not worship him. Because I don't know who told him that Jesus looks like that man. And he's telling people, don't put me in your churches and crosses. Me, I'm a man, I am an actor. I acted. But I'm saying, may God bring angels. Not the angels that we paint, but angels that come to serve. Now listen, these angels, men, three men are walking to Abraham. And the Bible calls them. But these are men with a stomach. Because Abraham tells them, simuingie kidogo angalau tuwapikie chakula. Siwalipikiwa, siwalikula. Malaika wale tunacharagua picha, hawakurani, hawasikia nja. Kwa hivyo, nataka kutangaza msimamo, kuna malaika watatumwa kwako. Usikoje wakuja na mabawa, hapana. Wacha malaika wa Mungu atumie. Na wewe ukitumwa kama malaika, usilinde kila siku unasema najua mimi nakuwa kama malaika. Alafu malaika kila siku ni wakati unatumwa kama malaika. Tumika. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh God, you are wonderful. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. I said in the first service, and I've said it here before, of this lady from England. She was coming from the Bonke Crusade. Her husband was the manager managing the crusade in Nairobi at Uruba. And then when the meeting ended, she was trying to get back to where she lived, above Jababu Road, those directions. And so she went up, and she was on Nairobi Hospital, that stretch between Nairobi Hospital, that stretch before you get to the roundabout. And then all of a sudden, men blocked her road, and they were armed. And the only thing she remembered was Jesus. Oh man, let's call Jesus, shall we? When there's problem, let's call Jesus. Let's not call our mother. Mommy will not hear you. Mommy, your mommy is not whatever. He's not a Holy Ghost that is all over with you. I know your mother is good. She took care of you. But when you are fighting with the devil, you don't need your mother around. She's okay. I know some of you even say something like Gatsubu when you have a problem. Who is Gatsubu? What can Gatsubu do for you? But the name Jesus. She called on Jesus. And then all of a sudden, a man appeared, a tall man. She says, a tall man appeared, and a strong man. He picked the first person, threw him on the pavement. Took the other one, threw him on the pavement. And then big on the lady, you can drive home. And the lady, like any one of us, ukifanywa vizuri unafanyaga nini? Naingia kwa kibia kutafuta hela kidogo upatie mtu wa Mungu, sio? Atakusaidia. So she was busy trying to open the door to give this pastor something. Akaenda akamtafuta chini ya gari, hakuna. Alafu ndio anasema huyo alikuwa malaika. I'm saying this because he told us
We had visited the UK and she told us of a miracle, how angels can be sent to come and serve us. They are angels of God protecting us. They don't have necessarily flips, but I bet you saw them. Well, you know, with all that, But you see, may the Lord bring angels that can serve us at our time in the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And when you have been used as an angel, please, watch out for you here, heaven. God to give you. There is a testimony that I will never forget myself. I will keep on talking about it so that it can humble me. Unajua kuna kaushuda kakukunyenyekeza, si ndio? Kila mtu hapa ana kaushuda kake. Kaka ukisema, unajua kakanikurudisha mbali kidogo. Na unajua Mungu ni maneno, sio? Yaani nimehubiri injili. Na niko na watoto wawili. Na tukitoka nyumbani tumejua hakuna chakula. Na hiyo ni ushuhuda ya kweli. Sasa wazee wazuri na hekima ya ulimwengu. Wazee wazuri na hekima ya wapi? Wanafanyaga around. Anazunguka ili watoto walie, wachoke, alale. Alafu naye aingie, alale. Sasa mimi na hekima yangu kaniambia nikakae kanisani kidogo, hakuna watu, washaenda na kanisa la mabati pale. Washaenda, lakini kakae kidogo. Nikifikiria labda malaika atatumwa akuje pale tuongee naye kwa sababu kilikuwa kimeumana. Nimekaa pale nikaona ofisa nikasema hapa na watu walienda kama walikuwa wakinisaidia si wangeliona tu niko na njaa. Niliwahubiria na hawakuona. Bwana huko hapa ufunuo acha niende nyumbani. So nikateremka. Na nilikuwa na gari nzuri sana. Mwambie jirani yako kuna gari nyingine nzuri. Ukisukuma na mabega alafu ujie ndani kutoka milima itakupeleka mpaka pale panaitwa base. Na wakati wa kuko magari mengi hata hapa hapo unajengwa. Kwa hivyo ni gari tatu nilisukuma na bega kaingia ndani kaenda base. Nilikuwa nikiishi hapo base. Alafu nikafungua gate. Mwambie jirani yako, sema mama niko na wakati kulikuwa na gate. Ndio sema mama niko na wakati kulikuwa kuna jengo nyumba ile tu, na kila nyumba ina gate. Kwa hiyo hiyo ilikuwa ile na nilikuwa na gate yangu. Kafungua gate. Kwa mlango nikakuta koto. Na koto likamejaa kako hapo hivi. Mimi nikaingia nikauliza hii koto ni mnajua mwenyewe? Akasema hapana. Hamjui? Hapana. Na mko ndani yeye na bado mna njaa eh? Oh, situchukue hiyo koto tuangalie kile kiko. Alafu tuone. Tulipokuwa tukakuta kweli hiyo koto ilikuwa na unga. Kweli hiyo kata ilikuwa na mchele. Kweli hiyo kata ilikuwa na sukari. Kweli hiyo kata ilikuwa na majani chai. Hiyo kata ilikuwa na chakula. Kwa hivyo nikaambia watu wangu pigeni, akija tutamlipa wakati wa kumlipa. Si ameleta koto tumwekee. Huyo jamaa hajarudi. Akirudi ninaweza mlipa. Lakini kama alikuwa malaika hata rudi. Inaniweka nikumbuke kuna malaika. Wanaweza kazi. May God send angels to protect, to provide for you in this year of open heaven. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to finish. I want to pray that God will help us to open our eyes. Because what we need is to open our eyes so that we can see they that are on our side, they are more. He that is in us is greater. That's all what we need to see. The vision, the revelation of who God is. We want to pray very, very quickly. Because again, it is not good just to preach and not to pray. We need to pray. Because I'm sure there are some of us here, the heavens have been closed. You have been stagnant. For 2018, there is no forward movement. And you feel that in this year of open heaven, that God needs to give you a vision for your future, for your business, for what you're doing. And I pray that it's going to happen. So if that is you, I would ask you to stand and come to the front. The ministry team are already here, and there are some out there ready to pray with you in the name of the Lord. You are praying that you don't want you to be stagnant anymore. You want God to open the heavens for you in 2019 in the name of Jesus. Come. kama unakuja kuja upesi. Sio unajijua. Sio unajijua. Sio unakuja upesi ili Bwana akutendee muujiza aliyopanga kukupatia wewe katika jina la Yesu.